For this lesson, use the Create New Design from File tool to open the vBlock clamp Fusion Archive file. Then, save the design to your active project. On the screen is a basic assembly. In Fusion 360, there are a few different ways to define three-dimensional objects. Every three-dimensional object that is contiguous, that has features that are built on one another, for example, if you were to extrude a sketch, that would create a body. If you were to add fillets to that body, they would just be part of the body. And if you placed a whole feature on that body, it is still just one body. However, to work in the context of an assembly and to make drawings of individual parts, those bodies have to be contained within a component. A component is another tier up, and it's so important that many people will tell you that rule one for using Fusion 360 is to create a component first before you start creating any sort of geometry. For the people that follow that tenet, this design would be a poor example, because when this design was created, a sketch was made, and then a body was extruded without creating a component. In future lessons, you'll see how to rectify that if you need to create a component from that body. But let's take a look at the browser and understand what the structure looks like, and understand what a component's structure looks like. So every design in Fusion 360 to another design is a component. So at the top, I see I have a vBlock clamp. And looking at the icon, it shows me that there is more than one component inside of this design. A component is easy to spot because it has its own origin, can contain its own sketches and bodies. It can also contain its own joints. It can also contain a number of different elements. If this design only contained bodies, you would not be able to apply assembly joints between just the bodies. Looking down the browser, we see the sketches that were used, and then we see a component. It too has multiple components within it. So let's expand it. We see that it has its own origin folder. It has a joints folder. And then there are two more components. Components can not only contain bodies, joints, sketches, but they can also contain other components. But if we expand one of those components, we'll see that, as you would expect, it has its own origin, it has its own bodies, and it has its own sketches. Looking to the browser is a great first step in understanding how your design is structured and whether or not everything is made into a component or, as in this design, you have a body that is sitting at the top level that has limited assembly functions because it's only a body. Another important feature of components is it makes it easier to work in the context of your design. For example, if I want to make a modification to the clamp yoke, rather than trying to find which features made up the clamp yoke, I can activate the clamp yoke by selecting the activation button on the right, and the timeline will limit itself to only show the features that are owned by that clamp yoke. If I were to switch over to the thumb screw, you'll see that the feature set changes. The icons will appear the same, but they are different sketches, different extrusions. Here's a thread feature that make up this component. Reactivating the top level of the design will take us back to the overall timeline. So, again, a body is going to be anything that's generating 3D geometry. Whether that body is a solid body, a freeform body, a mesh body, it will be making the 3D geometry. To really leverage that body, you need to have it inside of a component. With this course being focused on assemblies, components will be a key element of the datasets that we use.